Yesterday, a little bit cooler, I do have to admit. Temperatures only got up into the upper 70s. 78 was a high here in Eugene, a touch warmer in Corvallis. Roseburg also at 78, mid-60s along the coast once again, and warmer when you head east of the Cascades. 85 was a high temperature there in Redmond, and then upper 80s and a few low 90s when you get all the way over to the eastern side of the state. Now, that high temperature of 78, that's just 3 degrees below average for this time of year, so that average is starting to come down. We've reached that peak of the summer season, but it's not over just yet. Summer continues all the way through the end of September, and on average September is warmer than even June is. So again, we're not going to enter into fall just yet, but it has sort of felt like it the past couple days. Overnight we've been warm because of the extra cloud cover, 59 when typically we're down closer to 50 degrees, and we're seeing those clouds and warmer temperatures again this morning as well. You can see all across western Washington, then from the Oregon Cascades out to the beach, seeing that cloud cover. And when you look offshore off the coast of Washington, even seeing a little bit of light rain out there this morning and a few thunder showers popping up in that. All that's going to stay to the north of us, so we'll just see the extra cloud cover moving in this morning. Scattered clouds out at the airport. Current temperatures 52 degrees, and those winds out of the southwest this morning at about 3 miles per hour. You may be thinking, with the cooler weather and even the little light rain that we saw, that fire danger would be coming down. But here's the thing. We did not see enough rain to really change all those dry fuels out there. So that continues to be in the high category. If you are heading out to do some camping this weekend, there's still some fire restrictions in place, and we still have several large fires burning in the Cascades and across southern part of the state. So you do want to check that out before you head up that way. Now, we do have a trough of low pressure sitting just offshore, and that's part of the reason why we've seen some cooler temperatures the past couple days. And this area of low pressure is what's going to be spinning through those clouds and even some light rain potentially here tomorrow morning. Now, this is all going to move up to the northeast for the second half of the week and weekend, and that's where we will return to those summer-like conditions. So here's what I'm expecting for cloud cover. This morning, those clouds up to the edge of the Cascades, but they move back to the coast this afternoon. So we'll see those sun breaks return. Then as we head into Wednesday, those clouds will be a little bit thicker. We could see a little bit of light drizzle from this in the valley and some isolated showers for the coast and up north from Portland into Seattle. That'll still break up for the second half of the day, though. Thursday will be a transition day with morning clouds, afternoon sunshine, and then by Friday, we get back to more sunshine and warmer temperatures to go with it. So for the coast, you'll look at those mid-60s again today. Sun breaks this afternoon, wind staying from the west, 5 to 10 miles per hour. Again, a few isolated showers early Wednesday. Otherwise, we get back to sunny skies starting Friday. For the Umpqua Basin, mid to upper 70s, so cooler today for you as well. Staying partly cloudy with those winds out of the northwest. One more day in the 70s on Wednesday before we get back to the 80s Thursday and all the way through the weekend. Cascades are looking in the upper 60s, partly cloudy there today. A little bit cooler for those of you in central Oregon, staying sunny and mild with winds out of the west. Staying in the 70s Wednesday and Thursday before returning to the 80s for Labor Day weekend. And for the valley, we're looking at mid to upper 70s, about 77 today in Eugene. Morning clouds, back to sunshine this afternoon. Few isolated sprinkles early Wednesday. Otherwise, by Friday, the sunshine returns and we see low 80s for Labor Day weekend.